Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace, the risen Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all. In today's second reading, St. Paul tells us that none of us lives for himself, and no one dies for oneself. The times our pride and selfishness have shielded us from embracing the gifts of others. Let us ask for mercy. Lord Jesus, show us a way to forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you lift up the lowly and forgotten. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again to bring us into life everlasting. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let's give glory and praise to God and sing. God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbors your justice. Then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sin? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days, set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments, hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are in the Lord. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, the debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying him back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. But when that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he had paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, you wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today's first reading from Sirach says, remember your last days, set enmity aside, remember death and decay, and cease from sin. We do not know the time or the hour when the Lord will call us home, and so we need to be diligent at all times, trusting the Lord and walking with the Lord in everything that we say and do. St. Benedict, about 1,500 years ago, said, keep death daily before your eyes. Keep death daily before your eyes. In other words, if we do that every day, we will be focused on the Lord, focused on what matters, our family, friends, again, our relationship with God and others, and loving the Lord with all of our heart, soul, strength, and mind, and loving our neighbor as ourselves. So we do that every day. We keep the Lord in our minds and hearts. We keep death daily before our eyes. And that way we will be focused on the Lord in everything we say and do. It also says in today's reading from Sirach, get rid of all enmity, meaning hostility. So we need to forgive and forget. We, as we know, we've hurt others, I've hurt others, and we've all been hurt in many ways, but we need to forgive and we need to forget, you know, to, again, to love everyone in our lives, everyone, and trust in the Lord with everything we say and do. But again, let go and let God, because if we are holding a grudge, it is hurting our souls, and our souls proclaim the greatness of the Lord, and our spirits rejoice in God, our Savior. And so again, we get rid of enmity and anger, and so that we are free to love and to honor and to serve the Lord in everything we say and do. In today's reading from Romans, it says, while we live, we are responsible to the Lord, and when we die, we are servants. So we are responsible to the Lord. As Catholic Christian disciples, baptized and confirmed in the faith, we are responsible to the Lord, loving again the Lord with all of our hearts, our souls, our strength, and our mind, loving our neighbor as ourselves, praying without ceasing, being compassionate, and being the people of love that the Lord calls us to be in our lives. So last week, the nation commemorated the attacks on the World Trade Center, the horrific things on September 11, 2001, and that the nation came together. It was so full of love and compassion and mercy. I remember I was in the seminary, and for several days, roughly 10 days or so, on the TV, I called them the ticker tapes. It was the beginning of things being on the bottom of the TV. You see it all the time now, but it was saying all the time, prayer service here and there, just constant. And so that attitude of prayer, churches were packed, people were very loving and compassionate. And that's what the Lord calls us to do, loving and compassionate and forgiving with in every aspect of our lives. And so the Spirit of 9/11, the Holy Spirit was guiding us in the nation, and we ask the Holy Spirit to continue to guide us on our pilgrim way. Today's Gospel, Matthew says, Peter says to Jesus, Lord, when my brother wrongs me, how often must I forgive? 7 times? And the Lord says, no, 70 times, 7 times. So if we want to be forgiven, we have to forgive. Like in today's gospel, the king says that he's trying to make up the debts, in order for us to forgive, we need to be forgiven. And that's what we have to do. We have to love and honor the Lord in everything we say and do in our lives. So we pray for the Lord for his wisdom, strength, and peace to constantly do his will and to love the Lord with every ounce of our being. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God for God, light for light, true God for true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who hath spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world. With gratitude for God's presence among us, let us place before the Lord our prayers and petitions.
We pray for the church. May we always forgive and welcome those who have lost hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for world leaders. May they heed the cry of those who cry out for justice and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our country and all who call it home. May we be a people who seek justice for the oppressed and forgotten. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for young people who have been forsaken by families, schools, the criminal justice system, and law enforcement. May they find someone who believes in their potential. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for families that have been estranged. May they be healed and restored to a loving relationship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an abiding respect for God's gift of human life. May we treasure the lives of all people, in particular those who live on the margins of society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for people of all faiths. May we be united during this liturgical season of creation to reflect, pray, and act for justice and peace for all, and the glorification and praise of our God, our Creator. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died. May they rest in the peace of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the people of our parish for whom our Mass is offered. May we hope to give glory to God by serving the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray. Gracious God, you inspire disciples across generations to be people of mercy and hope. Receive our prayers that we may be strengthened to proclaim your word to all those we meet today and always. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these, your servants' offerings, and what each has offered to the honor of your name, and serve the salvation of all through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You so love the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, to give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of pain. Saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we we offer you thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Helena and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Austin Anthony, our Bishop, the order bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you, and your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace the Lord be with you always. And salute each other, a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul.
Thank you.
Invite those who are watching our live stream. Please pray for us. We pray for you that we grow in holiness and love the Lord every day of our lives. That we can give the Lord glory and praise forever in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let us pray. In the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The announcement, several announcements here. 4:30, join us for our annual parish potluck today at the Mass in the Social Center with guest speaker Jacob Kuntz, Executive Director of the Helena Area Habitat for Humanity. Join us for the 4 Days for Life kickoff rally on September 26th at 6:15 p.m. in the Social Center. Bishop Vedder will be here at the 4:30 Mass on September 30th for his annual parish visit. We cordially invite you for dinner after Mass in the Social Center. Please RSVP by September 25th, via flock notes, or by calling the parish office. We need help with side dishes, salads, desserts, and cleanup. If you are able to help, please sign up on the kiosk in the gathering space or on flock note. Our basket auction will be on October 7th. The parish office is now accepting auction items that are now new or used, but in excellent condition. Items are due on Tuesday, September 26th. All proceeds support our annual Thanksgiving food outreach program, which provides groceries for full Thanksgiving dinner to over 300 Helena families in need. Another reminder, there will be no Mass this week. We're having our priest gathering at the Copper Canyon Butte, and so there will be Mass Friday, but no Mass Monday through Thursday. The Lord be with you.
And
Almighty God bless the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.